Houston, did you copy? Over.
The Apollo 11 crew blazes back to Earth at 6,000 miles per hour.
Hey, Houston, you suppose you could turn the Earth a little bit so we could get a little bit more than just water?
In Houston, mission controllers prepare to celebrate the return of the world's first lunar landing.
Roger, 11. I don't think we got much control over that. Looks like you'll have to settle for the water.
At Hickam Air Force Base, Air Force meteorologists in a top-secret spy program know something NASA doesn't. Mother Nature plans to greet the three American heroes with a powerful storm.
There were folks in the military who were looking at where the Apollo 11 landing site was and knew that there was a typhoon heading that way at about the time the crew was going to be there.
Air Force meteorologists have no choice but to break rank. Sitting on the classified intelligence could prove to be a national disaster.
They managed to find a way to discreetly tell NASA that we can't tell you how we know this, but there is this weather storm coming, and you might want to move to the splashdown site for Apollo 11.
Moving a splashdown site means rerouting an entire carrier task force. It's not an easy sell.
Recovering a crew is a pretty intensive effort. There was a large number of U.S. military personnel involved, both on board those ships and also in the air to visually identify the crew when the spacecraft returned through the atmosphere.
The Navy reluctantly agrees to the plan. It's far too risky to turn a blind eye.
Two men had just landed on the moon for the very first time. To have everything on the dangerous mission work perfectly and then die in a regular storm on Earth would just be the worst way to end this mission.
With just 24 hours remaining, mission control scrambles, redirecting the Hornet to a splashdown site 250 miles away.
And the question is, could NASA have adjusted enough time to make sure the fleet was in the right spot?
Apollo 11, Houston, some last-minute updates here. The weather is clobbering in at our targeted landing point, so we're going to move you over.
Roger.
On July 24th, Apollo 11 bursts through the atmosphere. As its parachutes deploy, the crew is met with clear skies and a calm sea. President Nixon waits on board the USS Hornet to welcome the astronauts back to Earth. Few people know just how close the crew came to a watery grave. Disaster provides a sobering lesson. NASA engineers may be able to challenge the laws of physics, but nature will always be there to flex her muscles.
Mother Nature is not to be messed with, and weather can, you know, impinge on space operations in lots and lots of different ways.
In just 4 months, the American space program will be tested by nature once more. Only this time, NASA refuses to heed the warning signs.